Thank you and good afternoon. My name is Kevin Gillick, and I'm the executive director of an industry specification development body known as GlobalPlatform. How many people here have any knowledge of GlobalPlatform as an organization? Very few. Okay, so hopefully you'll walk away from this 20 minutes that we share with a little bit of understanding of what we do and how you might be able to apply it. Now, I can't cover everything in 20 minutes, but hopefully enough just to help you understand that there are some tools out there, there are some industry offerings that are freely available to you to help you in your mobile deployment strategy, both from a security standpoint as well as from an interoperability and future-proofing standpoint. But let me start just first by setting some context about the underlying beliefs of the GlobalPlatform membership body. And setting some context to do that, the first thing I want to talk about is setting some context around increasing trust. Now, today, everyone, all of us, are downloading applications to our mobile handsets or our tablets. And a lot of these applications are intrinsically whimsical in nature. We're looking at our airplane mileage accumulation. We're maybe getting a hotel reservation. We're checking the stock market to see if the Dow went up or down. The applications that we have abundantly available to us from an app store maybe have a lower bar in terms of their security requirement, and therefore the trust threshold with you doesn't have to be as high. But we're moving into an era right now where the applications that we will demand are going to have more and more value associated with them. Payment, authentication, identity, things that are going to have to be safeguarded for your protection and interest as well as the service provider's protection and interest. So we're going to need to put in more security around these solutions when we deploy our mobile strategy. And the problem is then we face this trade-off. The trade-off is historically when I add more and more levels of security to build trust, it means I'm lowering the convenience level for the end user, which makes my product or service maybe less desirable in their mind because I've had to raise the bar on security and trust. Well, these two competing forces are difficult to manage, but it's necessary to manage it because as more applications move onto the mobile platform, it invites more malicious behavior on the mobile platform. There's more hooliganism, more malware. Fact is, there's more people carrying around mobile handsets today than there are people who have personal computers. So it's natural that that be the next point of attack, particularly because of the migration of rich applications over to that platform. So that leaves us saying, you know what, if we're going to move our applications over to that platform, we're going to have to make some investments in security. And those investments aren't cheap necessarily, but it means that I have to make those investments in ways that have some solid underpinning, some good rationale behind it. We believe, the GlobalPlatform organization, we believe that having that trust path, and a trust path I mean everything that goes on in the space between the device that I'm holding and the services in the back room in the cloud. With those two endpoints in mind, we need to have a trust path established as an underpinning of any good mobile strategy, and that relates to any handset that you might want to make use of in your deployment. All right, other context setting. The threats are real. And these little magazine clippings and quotes that you see back here, this is already out of date. In the time that we've been here at RSA this week, there's probably been more threats that'll be in the news soon. So everything here is obsolete, but it's current. And it means these threats are real and we have to protect ourselves from them. So how do we do that? Well, one of the things we do is we look at device technologies. And to set context a little bit further, when you look at the device itself, you've got three technologies that are available to be examined. One of them is the rich and open operating system, which gives you a lot of flexibility, a lot of memory storage, a lot of great user interface capabilities, but it's not very good at preventing attacks. It's a very porous operational environment. And to pass critical information through that porous path is a bit risky. So you add some other core componentry. You add something called a trusted execution environment, or the TEE, which resides in parallel with a rich operating system, gives you a little less functionality, but much more protection in terms of anything that resides in the mobile handset or anything that needs to communicate with the third such technology, which is the secure element. And that secure element in the handset, the mobile platform, not a lot of functionality, but very, very hardened security for the protection of things like credentials and cryptographic keys, things of that nature. So you've got these technologies at your disposal, and I suspect most of you in this room are very aware of what an open operating system is, and very aware what a TEE is, as well as a secure element. So I'm not really here to talk to you or teach you about three enabling technologies. What I'm here to impart is a strategy, a philosophy about mobile deployment that can take use of these technologies in a standard way, thus reducing your costs to market and opening up for you the opportunity for more of a mass market. So let me talk to you about GlobalPlatform's positioning. We are an organization that plays in two of those three platform areas. We're not in the rich OS area, but we are in fact the organization that is standardizing the technology around trusted execution environment and the secure element, so that the management of applications on those secure platforms can be done in a standard and uniform way. So this is the space that GlobalPlatform plays in. And to paint it a little bit differently on this slide, you see I just encircled the lower two of this hierarchy of three component technologies. So when you think about secure element and you think about trusted execution environment, there's two ways that you can think about this. You can think about it around the fact that the TEE is out there today. It's right on your mobile handset today. Almost every mobile handset today has a trusted execution environment functionality within it. Today it may not be used, it may not be turned on, nobody's had access to it, but it's there. The secure element. You may have an embedded chipset in your phone, you may have a removable UICC, you may have a smart micro SD, but you've got some kind of secure element. The key here is, do they all look the same and are they the same to the service provider out there who wants to build an application and deploy it securely in a trusted manner to a target device without any foreknowledge of what that device is? I have no knowledge if it's from Samsung, no knowledge if it's from Huawei, no knowledge if it's from Motorola, nor do I know if the chipset in it is embedded chipset or removable chipset, but I want to be able to develop an application one way and support it and lifecycle manage it in one way, regardless of the underlying platform that I can't see, number one, and number two, and most likely to reach through the network services of an independent third party, like a mobile network operator. So this is where standardizing these technologies becomes very key to a service deployment on any handset. Let me start first with the secure element. I'm providing here a definition for you, and I'm assuming you'll have access to these slides after our essay, so you can read this at your leisure. This is a definition that came out of Wikipedia, so you can go there as well. But basically what it's talking about is a tamper-resistant platform, typically a secure chip microcontroller. So we're talking about hardware here. People use the term sometimes secure element in the cloud. We've heard this new term, SE in the cloud. A secure element is hardware. So there's other functionality that's going to the cloud, but to call it secure element is actually a misuse of term. So I want to put you back into the real definition. We're talking about hardware here. Now there are nuances and differences between the deployment of this hardware, if it's in a UICC SIM form factor, or if it's an embedded chipset, or if it's a micro SD card. What GlobalPlatform has done, its members have done, has developed the specification set that makes all of these identical in terms of the interface and the functionality. So when an outside party decides to create a rich application for payment or identity or authentication, one of those that really needs to be protected, if they develop it to a global platform set of APIs to interface with this underlying hardware, it will functionally behave the same no matter which hardware is in the handset that you're holding. Now, this is very important. It's important to EMVCO. As you know, here in the United States, we're migrating to chip credit debit payment. Should EMVCO want to put in place a methodology in North America to deploy that on mobile handsets, they're going to want to know that they can provision rich applications like that to a handset in the same way that they can control the quality and the integrity of the application today on a smart card form factor. So it's been endorsed by EMVCO, it's been endorsed by GSMA as a methodology to perform this capability. And as you can see, I put a number of logos down there at the bottom. Today there are a number of independent companies who have secure element product available on the market today that has gone through third-party verification, test, and certification. So as part of a mobile strategy today, if you wanted to create an app and download it to a secure element, any of the secure elements from those companies will allow the applications to behave in a common way. Now, if we look at the layer above that, the trusted execution environment, I also have here a definition, comes from Wikipedia, that talks about this being a secure area, a processor in the mobile handset that guarantees that data is stored, processed, and protected in a trusted environment, and in this environment is done so alongside but independent of the rich operating system. Three important use cases for the trusted execution environment. One is premium content protection, digital rights management. When we start thinking about streaming video, electronic books, music, this is becoming increasingly important to those providers in order to protect the licensing rights to that data, to that content. Second use case is mobile financial services, where we need to authenticate the users and authenticate the transactions. And the third area really shouldn't say corporate. It says corporate on this slide, but it should say enterprise. Because what we're talking about is whether it's a private sector or a public sector enterprise, we're moving into a space where user authentication and data encryption on mobile devices is becoming more important, particularly when the smartphone is being moved into a bring-your-own-device or BYOD environment. And you have to now isolate corporate assets or government assets from private assets that reside on platforms purchased by an employee or a contractor. So these are very important use cases as part of the mobile deployment strategy. Now, I've included this slide just as backup for you when you leave here, but it basically illustrates the trusted execution environment resident alongside the rich OS. What's important here is that the Global Platform membership has created a toolkit around this capability. The toolkit acknowledges that the service provider, the person who wants to put this application and protect it on the phone, wants to do things in a uniform way. We want to be able to do device authentication the same way, regardless of the device, user authentication, digital signature and encryption, secure communications from the trusted execution environment itself to the secure element. We'd like to have some uniform way to always do that. So we've put in a toolkit that deals with all of those variables and allows somebody to say, when I develop my application, I can do it one way, knowing the path through the trusted execution environment has been standardized, and therefore, if it is reliant on the underlying secure element, even the communication from the TEE to the SE and the access control rights to the SE have also been vetted by the industry at large and are now available to me freely, and I can develop accordingly. Now, there's a growing momentum for this standardization of the TEE. There are system-on-chip providers, handset manufacturers, service providers, test laboratories. You can look at the logos that you see here on the slide and understand that there is a large community of people who recognize that as the applications become richer and richer on mobile platform, The need to have a uniform set of agreed-upon rules goes up. In the absence of that, you deny yourselves the opportunity to have true interoperability, true multi-source selection across component providers, or any opportunity to ensure backward compatibility as technology inevitably moves forward to the next generation. So there's quite a bit of traction around this. Now, when I say complying with standards, compliance is really an important word. To comply means to have gone through some rigorous test and examination where the TEE that you develop, the secure element that you offer, has to go to an independent third party and prove through functional test that all of the capabilities inherent in the spec have been proven in a lab to function the same way so that an application deployed to that technology will always be behaviorally the same in the marketplace. There's a lot of test tools out there today from a lot of companies, a lot of laboratories on all continents of the world, and a very large body of product out on the public website today, along with its certificates of authentication for the industry to choose. Now let me talk to you about resources. These are the Global Platform members today. We have about, I think at last count, 126 member companies. They participate in the organization in various ways, but what they do through membership is adhere to our philosophy of coming together, developing specifications that once they are fully vetted within the organization, are posted to our public website and are available for download for free for any commercial enterprise to use their own research and development dollars to develop product, commercialize it for your benefit, or for any procurement entity to specify to these specifications so that the tender and bid responses that they receive have to come in abidance with something that's known and published. Now, by freely available, what I mean is when these specs are written by the membership as part of helping the industry move forward with a mobile strategy, it means that there's no royalty implications back to the organization. You take them, you develop to them, they're free. You buy the technology from any of the providers who have gone through qualified laboratories, aside from paying their commercial prices, there's nothing that comes back to Global Platform of the membership. This is our model. It's been that model since 1999. We're in our 15th year, and this technology today is widely, widely deployed. If you go to our website, www.globalplatform.org, you will find the specifications, you will find implementation guides, you will find industry-specific white papers, interviews, much there that will be beneficial and helpful to you. So the resources are there. If your organization isn't involved today and the notion of getting involved is of interest to you, the website will tell you how to do that, or you can see me directly as well. Those are my prepared comments. I'm finished a little bit ahead of time, so I'll leave you with just a small ad lib. If you think about when smart card technology was first introduced, and we're talking decades ago, every operating system was different, every deployment was different, everyone who wrote an application had to write it for that specific operating environment. When you did the personalization function to personalize it for a function, the perso apps were unique to an operating environment. They were even unique to the personalization machinery. Nothing was standard. Every smart card, smart chip deployment was tightly vertically integrated, non-transferable, and gated any chance for mass market adoption. The philosophy we're talking about here is one that learns from the history of smart card deployment and changes the paradigm for secure element and the trusted execution environment that resides above it. That is how we are able to look to the future and say, how do we go about deploying applications in a secure way onto any handset and leave open for the potential to create the mass market? Standards is the way to accomplish that, and I thank you for the opportunity to be here today to tell you a little bit about the standards that are coming out of Global Platform. Thank you very much. Thank you.